Assalamu alaikum. Today I'm going to be showing you a little bit of an insight into this dress. Don't know how well you can see this, but it's design 181. It's in like a peachy color, and the first thing we've done is it comes as semi-sewn. Now the semi-sewn is generally on a quite a large size, and if it's a quite a petite size that you're sewing this in, then you will need to pull fair pieces apart in order to get a good shape. So I requested the person who bought this in to pull this apart, and I'll go through the pieces with you, and then I'll show you whereabouts I'm going to be doing the modifications. So the part of the skirt, this is the top portion of the skirt, the top side, the bottom side, and this has like a stitched up open type of I have a feeling that these are meant to be opened up later on. What I'm going to do is I am going to open these up, because the thing that we need a waist, quite narrow waist, and in order to get the narrow waist, we're going to have to cut into this. Either if we take too much out from the side panels, then the center one, they're going to be misproportioned. So my aim is to try and get a sort of like a equal, you know, equal width. I'm not going to do anything. This is embroidery, so I'm not going to mess about with, because it's so fine on the edge, I'm not going to mess about with this. But the center panels, I'm going to be opening them, tightening them up, all the center panels, and then taking some from the side here. So this is the front. I'll just go through the pieces and then we'll go through the alterations. This is the back. Again, this has got panels, and some of these panels I've had them slightly opened up, so that, again, this is like a kalidar. So the kalis, the panels, kalis are panels, by the way, we need to take them in so that the width on the waist is narrowed down. So this is the back panel. On the back there is just the border embroidery. Okay, other portions to this is the sleeves. They were just basically just roughly attached. They've not been cut or anything. It's got full sleeves. So again, we're going to make sure that this is centered out properly, and once centered out, we're going to cut the shape of the sleeves. And then this was pieces that were attached on top of where the bodice and the skirt were connected, and this is the piece, waistline piece, two pieces that were attached on. And then we've got the galati. This is the collar, band collar, for the dress, and this is the top portion of the dress. Now the top portion of the dress, this has been roughly stitched on where it's got no shape. This is a straight piece. Obviously you need to pull it apart, you need to make the neckline, and then the band needs to be attached on, but this seam in the center needs to be deattached as well. And then once that's done, this will get shaped and get attached back onto the skirt portion. This is the bodice, and then the lace is going to get attached back on. So this was the portion of the skirt, the dress portion. This is the skirt. Again, this is a lenga skirt. It comes as fully stitched. It's on a taffeta material with a border, and again the panels need to be narrowed down so that the waistline is brought in. So if you're like a size 16 or a size 14, 16 and so on, then that should be adequate. But if you're a size 8 or a 10, then that sort of needs to be halved. And the obvious best way to do this is to narrow it down from the waist. Okay, so again, we're going to attach the belt back on once we've narrowed all the pieces. And to go with this, it also comes with taffeta material for making the skirt also. So again, that's the taffeta material, and then it's got these patches for adding on to the trouser. So we're going to be making that quite simply. So the first thing I need to do now is to basically look at the measurements. I wrote the measurements. Okay, so it's a bust of 33, a waist of 30, hips of 36, and the full length is 52, and the skirt length is 40. Now, lengthwise, I don't think it should present a problem, but widthwise, it's quite considerable amount. So we'll do the easy bits first. If we left need this leaving at 30 inches, and at present it's okay, at present this is 45 inches, so we need to take 15 inches away from the pieces. Now I'm not going to bother undoing this. It's all overlocked and everything, but I'm going to take roughly about an inch. How many pieces is there? 14. Okay, so 14, half an inch I'm going to, be taking in on each one of these. So that's 1 inch, 2 inches, 3 inches. Yeah, that'll take about 7 inches off this, and which is basically what I'm looking at. So just to make sure that the length comes out okay. Because if this was too long, then you would need to take a little bit off from the top as well. So the length of the skirt is 40 inches. Just make sure. Okay, that's it's just a teeny weeny bit long. So we're going to take just a little bit off, because it's going to get the belt reattached on as well. And you don't want it too long, because then what would happen is the waistline. So we're going to take about an inch and a half off from the top, which means that once we take this off, the waistline becomes even wider. But at least it's given us an idea of just how much we're going to take off. So I'm going to be doing this, get that sorted, and then get the layout for, I think, one piece at a time. Okay, so this is the bodice part, and we've got to cut the shape for the armholes. Measure for the shoulder area, and then this is quite a small size, so notch it for the center back, and basically I've slightly shaped it, taken the piece out for the armhole, that's the back, and then the same for the front. Now the piece of the lining is already attached to this. We're going to cut this on the right so that it's visible and you can see what we're doing. There's already a sort of like a pre-marking, and this marking is sort of in line with what we require for the cutting. It's quite weird because they've made the skirts so massive at the bottom, but yet at the top there isn't sufficient fabric for a very large size. So I don't know how a very large size, it's a bit of a contrast. Now there is a slight bit of a problem. I really don't think that this neckline is wide enough for attaching the, okay, what is going to give us, I'm going to just quickly measure what it's going to, opening is going to, because I don't think that's going to be able to go through the head. So we've got 4 and 4, and then we've got 3, 6 and 6, 12. I really don't think that's enough for, so we've got, a bit of a problem with what we're going to do with the neckline. Now the choice that we have is that when we attach this, we can now for a child this is not too bad, but when you think of this as an adult's version. 21. Maybe just about. Maybe if we just about take it slightly in at the back, we might just squeeze. Otherwise, the alternative is, right, is to either put deeper or to apply a zip at the back. I don't know if that's making sense to you if you're watching and trying to follow the video. Obviously this tutorial is for useful for any person who buys anything similar to this. Now I am going to put a side zip in so that it's easier to get on and off, and I'm going to slightly I won't do it at the front, but the back, I'm going to slightly dart this so that it narrows it down. Obviously these, without doing anything else, I'm going to just tighten all these and take away, because I need this narrowing down to about 15 inches.